Mario Bros. Wii!
Hello everyone, and welcome to my new Super Mario Bros. Wii walkthrough. Yes, I am back, and I am excited to start a new game. Not Sunshine for now, I have my reasons. So, let's start a brand new game. As you can see, I've already 100%ed this game without a guide, may I add. And this game's got some pretty cheap secrets, I have to say. I'm doing this completely solo, as usual. And let's get it started. Oh, it's Princess Peach's birthday. Oh, this is the holiest of holy days, and nothing could possibly go wrong. Hey, there's a delicious, delightful cake. What? Bowser Jr.? Oh my god, Trojan cake! Trojan cake! After them, they've got the princess! I have to say, that's probably the dumbest way she's ever gotten kidnapped. Wait, maybe the second dumbest. The dumbest was probably in the original New Super Mario Brothers, where she got just snatched up by Bowser Jr. and carried away. And those are two new power-ups that we'll be seeing in this game, as opposed to other Mario games before this one. Yeah, the propeller mushroom, the penguin suit. You shall see what they do soon enough. In a later world. The penguin suit doesn't come later. Here we go! Ooh, I'm so excited! And I'll also be cropping this into widescreen as well, so you're going to be able to see this gameplay in better quality than what I see, because there won't be black bars at the top and bottom of the screen. The first thing I'd like to show you here is Peach's castle, way off to the left here. As you collect star coins, more movies will unlock. So you hit this box. This movie right here, called Super Skills for World 1-1, costs 3 star coins to unlock. To unlock all the movies, you'll of course have to have all the coins. And you have to spend them too, so you can pick and choose which movies you want to see. They show you how to get through levels easily, or just show you where secrets are. Anyway, this arrow here, you'll unlock something later once you do a task, which I'll show you later as well. So let's just get right to the level. This is World 1-1. Oh, it's starting! Oh my goodness! Here we go. So, as you can see, it's a classic Mario side-scroller. We're looking for some power-ups. There's a mushroom! That gives you an extra hit, as well as makes you a little bit bigger, and because of your now a larger weight, you can now break through certain blocks of the ground pound. There's a pipe here. To go inside pipes, just press down. To jump, press the 2 button. To run, press the 1 button on your Wii remote. You get the idea. It's classic Mario, basically. It feels like an NES controller, really. D-pad, move left and right. Down to duck, up to, well, doesn't really seem to be much function for pressing up now, is there? Anyway, this is a P-switch, and when you press this, coins turn to blocks and vice versa. So use that time to collect the coins or traverse certain areas, which I'll get into later, like secret areas that you may need a P-switch to go through. And I miss one coin, but oh well. Who cares about coins? This game gives away lives like water, I'm serious. There's lives all over the place. Anyway, this is of course going to be a 100% run, excuse me. And that means I will have to collect all the star coins and find all the secret exits. Whenever you find a block that has coins popping out of it like that, you can just keep hitting them until they run out of coins. And whoops, that was stupid. And just keep moving on. I'm looking for the star coins, by the way, obviously. Oh, there's one right now! But how do you get up there? Oh, wait, what is this? A propeller mushroom? Shake the Wii remote to fly upwards. Woo! Now, you notice it just appeared in the upper left corner there. Well, they actually have an ordering system for the levels. The left one is the earliest coin that you can get, and the right one is the latest coin that you can get in the level. Now you notice that there's also some clouds up there. You can blow them away by using your propeller or just by doing a little spin, which is shaking the Wii remote without any power-up. It's not as effective as if you have a propeller power-up, of course. These are red coins. Whenever you hit that ring, a little red coin minigame will appear, and collecting all 8 red coins will give you a power-up. It's much different than any other red coin hunt in, well, I should say, much different than red coin hunts in usual 3D Mario games. I'm looking for the second coin now. I'm pretty sure there's a little alcove I have to go in, like this one right here. I said, oh wait, it's this pipe first, and then you come out there, excuse me. So, go in here, second coin will be up there. Here's another move that you're going to have to learn, it's called wall kicking. Just press against the wall that you want to kick, and you'll slide against it like that. See how that works? And as you're sliding, you can jump from one wall to the other. It's pretty easy to do once you get the hang of it. And then just go up the yellow pipe to exit the area. You can also pick up turtle shells by holding the 2 button, or I should say the run button, and hit that block as a secret block for a 1-up. As I said, this game gives away 1-ups like crazy. Pressing down will let you slide down a slope. Whenever you see a flower like this, spin next to it and you'll spin the flower, which will also give you whatever contents it's holding. Here's what I mean about grabbing and throwing a shell. It's basically hold and release to throw the shell. And that's really all there is to it. And there's the last star coin. And the goal should be coming up right ahead. The higher you get up on the goal post here, the better your reward will be. If you get all the way up to the top, like I'm gonna do here, you'll get a 1-up. Woo! Oh, yeah. Classicness! And depending on the number of seconds that are at the end of your time, I forgot the exact numbers, you'll get fireworks, which will let you get more points. Yeah, I forgot the number. Don't really care, because points or coins really don't matter in this game because of how they keep throwing 1-ups and coins and stuff like that at you. You just keep accumulating items and a whole load of stuff. Well, here's 1-2, our first cave level. Oh, we're going inside! This has got a pretty cool design to it. It's very crystally, very blue. I love the color contrast. I love the color combination, and it just looks really nice. Don't worry about any of these blocks. None of them will squish you. They're just there to throw you off a little bit. This is a POW block. If you grab it by shaking the Wii remote while standing next to it, then throwing it by releasing the 1 button. Yeah, you have to be holding the 1 button too. I forgot to say that. You'll drop the POW block and it'll shake and kill up enemies. I should say shake up and kill enemies. I guess I can't speak today. That's really all there is to POW blocks. It can also shake coins down, as you kind of seen there, which will be used a little bit later in this level. This platform reacts to your Wii remote. Like you see, you can't reach that block quite there. Oh, if you tilt to the right, you can, though. And there you go. And of course, you want to tilt to the left to go that way. Now, something is in here. Wait, this looks like a P-switch area. I betcha. Yeah. What the heck? Let me hit the block. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. And now go up here. And there's another star coin right there. If you'd like, you could wait until these blocks turn back into coins so you can collect more coins. If you want to, as I said, coins are really quite meaningless in this game because coins are typically for lives. When you collect 100 coins, you get an extra life, but when you collect the 1-up mushroom, you get 1, 2, and they're all over the place, dang it. But as they say, it's not how many lives you have, it's how many deaths you take per level for the, you know, to judge the difficulty. As you've seen there, I just did a ground pound there. You do that by pressing down in midair. This is a star. It'll make you invincible for a temporary amount of time. It'll also make you faster. And you'd also do this neat little somersault jump as well, which is pretty nice. I'm looking for a little ground pound area, which is right here. Keep in mind that star coin over there, it's on this screen, but I'm going to shake it down from this screen down into this screen with this POW block. This is the gimmick of the POW blocks as well, is to use them at the right places to get coins. Especially star coins. Got a 100%, baby. And out we go. Oh, don't worry about me going slow or anything like that. Things will pick up a lot faster. I always use the earlier parts just to explain things. So part 2 and on will be a lot quicker. I forgot to explain the ice flower here. It's just like a fire flower. When you press the Y button, you can throw ice balls, which I actually didn't explain the fire flower. But yeah, they work basically the same. But the ice ones, you can freeze enemies, of which you can pick up by shaking the Wii remote when you're standing next to them, not when they're on top of, you know, a pipe like that, or if they're rooted or something like that. That's also a problem, I forgot. Like, you can't pick up, piranha plants, but yeah, you can pick them up just like Koopa shells. Wait, you know what? I'll do this minigame. won't take too long, and it's not that hard to do. There we go. Here's a fire flower. Good thing I did that. Yeah, these pretty much kill enemies outright instead of freezing them, basically. Yeah, you should know a fire flower if you've ever played a Mario game. Come on, man. And out this pipe, and that's pretty much the end of 1-2. As you can see, there's another one of these things here. Oh, this is what I mean about shaking in midair. If you do a little shake, you'll get a little more air time. Now, that seems pretty useless, but you can sometimes use that to gain... Or I should say, you can always use it to gain more distance on your jumps, and you can sometimes use it to offset the timing of things that you would normally get hit on. Like, I just used it to get a little more air to my jump and get the one up at the top of that flagpole. So, let's go over to 1-3.
Yeah.
Oh, and this is going to be a split path here, so I might as well show the mushroom house. Red mushroom houses, when you go into them, a little mini-game will start. It's like a matching mini-game. When you collect pairs of the same item, you'll get that item. So, let's go into this door. Yes, I am feeling lucky, Toad! You punk. I just had to make that reference. So, power-up panels, yeah, that's the name of the mini-game. If you match two of Bowser or Bowser Jr.'s heads, the game is over. Climb on these things, you just press up and you'll latch right onto them. That's really all there is to it. Press the B button to flip over the panels. This is a classic thing from Super Mario World. Ooh, there's a pear, so that means I got a mushroom. Uh-oh, Bowser head, not good. I don't want to find another Bowser head. I want some more items, so there's Bowser Jr. There's another pear. Oh, I lost. Well, I got three pears anyway. That's good enough for me. You usually don't get all the pears, let's just say that. The chances of you getting all the pears is pretty low. In fact, I've never done it. I'm sure there has been people, you know, there have been people that have done it. Anyway, let's do one more level and, yeah, I'll do one more level and end out this part. This is 1-. Wait, actually, come to think of it, this one's got a secret exit along with it, so I'm actually gonna end it off here. So I'll see you guys in the next part. I hope you enjoyed.